Hi, Hiram here. I want to warn you right now, if you didn't read that sign that I had at the beginning of the video, this video has the potential for mayhem. If you're stupid or, you know, just don't care, you could hurt yourself with this. If you want to keep on watching, please do, but I'm not going to be held responsible. I've been making these remote fuel feeders. I've been using these little primer bulbs. And the problem with these is if you're going to do something for long term, like the electricity's gone out and you want to heat up water and stuff around the house, this little thing, you got to pump and pump and pump to get stuff filled up, sort of like with the Trangia or something. So, I mean, this is nice. This is great for, I even think, for hiking and camping and stuff. But for a long term thing, like I said, the power goes out, this can be a bit of a pain. So I got to thinking, I have these things around the house that I bought at Goodwill. These are those personal misters that, you know, you fill them with water. They come in a little bag and stuff. But you fill them with water, you pump up the power on them. And then it's got a little nozzle with a shutoff valve. Now this one's leaking. See, it's a little bit open. There we go, that's close. So it's supposed to spray you with water, which then it evaporates and cools you off. Well, these things don't work here in Pennsylvania. Just too much humidity in the air. But I was thinking that maybe this might work for a shower again in the case of power going off. You could warm up some water on your Trangia, put it in here, spray yourself, wash down, and then spray yourself off. But this nozzle that's on this thing is just way too fine. I gotta find some other nozzles to put in here. But I'm still working on that idea for a camp shower or emergency shower. I bought another one, this smaller version, and I thought, I wonder if I could fill this with alcohol, cut off that nozzle that was on the end of the tube, put in a little brass fitting. I don't know if you can see it there. I put a brass fitting in so that I could put on the silicone hose that I use and the remote feeder pipe. That's the thing that goes into, say, the Trangia, just like that. Now, I've had methanol setting in this for it's been in here for a week now under pressure, and I don't see any softening or anything getting gummy, so maybe this thing will hold up to methanol or alcohol. What the idea is, I hope you can see this, is this has a little on-off valve, so when it's perpendicular like that, it means that it's shut off. When the handle is parallel to the hose, that's turned on. So let's see what happens here. Turn this on. It's been pumped up. I think it's been pumped up. Yep. With alcohol in here. And this is how it comes out. Come on. Kind of hard to do this one-handed. See that? Fills up nice and it shuts off. No splashing, no anything. Just kind of goes in there. So I'm thinking, let me put that out of the way. Let me light up the Trangia here. Get this thing going. Again, this is something that I'm doing. You don't have to if you don't feel confident in your ability to handle this kind of stuff. Don't do this. I do this so that you don't have to. Okay, the jets are going. I hope you can see this. I don't know what's wrong with my light here. There's the jets going. Or it was. There we go. Let's say this has been running for a while. I want to refill it without having to take everything all apart, which is what they tell you to do. You have to let this cool off because you don't want to go pouring alcohol into this while it's hot. But with something like this feeder pipe, you can put that there and get past the flames. Why'd it jump like that? You can get past the flames, and now when I pump alcohol in there, it's going into the Trangia. So let's see what happens here. Okay, it's going in, filling it up, no splattering around. Take this out. Now when you bring it out, there may be some flames on it, but no big deal. So this might be an idea, just an idea. Again, for some time, like in an emergency type thing where you need a lot of heating up of water and stuff, you don't want to be shutting it down, putting it on and everything. This might just work. Now this is this one. I can't guarantee that other pumps like this thing, there's all kinds of different ones out there on the market, that they might dissolve in alcohol. But like I said, this one's been going for a week under pressure, and nothing's happened to it so far. So I like this. This might be a good idea. I still like the old idea with the bubble pump for something that you're just making a meal or whatever, but this might work for emergencies. So I thought I'd share that. I look forward to your input, questions, remarks, helpful suggestions. And as always, watch for my buddy Max. Bye now.